It wasn't long ago that people thought laptops were going to go away because of the introduction of tablets. It's sort of gone the other way around, and we've got three of the best laptops that you can buy in 2019, and we're going to compare them. This is the Huawei MateBook X Pro, the Dell XPS 13, and the latest MacBook Air. So we're going to compare them in five different categories, starting with the price. And although there's various different prices depending on which models you buy and processors and SKUs and all that kind of jazz, we're just going to talk about the starting price because that keeps it simple. So the X Pro starts at €1,599, and we don't really know what the UK and US prices are going to be, but it is more than last year's model and it's the most expensive out of these three laptops. Moving on to the Dell XPS 13, this is actually cheaper for this year. So this comes in at £939, or even less in dollars, so this is $899, and that's because Dell has introduced basically a lower spec model, so that's why it's cheaper. So this is the cheapest out of the three if you're on a tight budget. So moving on to the MacBook Air, and this is more expensive than its predecessor, as you would imagine. And comes in at £1,199 or dollars, same price in pounds or dollars. So this is the middle of the pack on price. So the winner of round one, the Dell XPS. So round two is design, and there's not a huge amount in it, but let's look at the details, because when you're talking flagship laptops, it does come down to the details. Now the MacBook Air, if we go in reverse order from round one, comes in at 15.6 millimeters at its thickest point and 1.25 kilograms. Now that is pretty thin and light, but the Dell XPS does beat that figure on both counts. It comes in at just 11.6 millimeters and just 1.23 kilograms. So again, it's not much, but it does win. And then moving on to the X Pro, this comes in sort of in the middle on thickness, so this is 14.6 millimeters thick, and it's the heaviest out of the three at 1.33 kilograms. Now, there is a little bit of a bonus round here because we're not gonna talk about ports completely, but because they all have things like USB-C and Thunderbolt, but we do wanna point out that although the X Pro is a bit thicker and heavier, it does come with a Type-C USB port, so that's pretty cool. So the winner of round two, well, the XPS takes it again. So let's move on to round three, and that's core specs. Now, obviously that's a little bit difficult to compare because it depends which model you buy and how much money you want to spend. But let's look at the base model. So again, with the X Pro, obviously this is the most expensive model, so it's not surprising that you're gonna get the best specs. This comes with at least a Core i5, 8 GB of RAM, 512 GB of storage, and a dedicated graphics card in the form of an NVIDIA GeForce MX250. Whereas the Dell XPS starts at a Core i3, but you can spec up to a Core i5 or a Core i7, and it has at least 4 GB of RAM and 128 GB of storage, but that's gonna be an integrated graphics card. So moving over to the MacBook, this is the most restricted when it comes to specs because it has to come with a Core i5. Now you can customize things like the RAM and storage, and it comes with at least 8 GB and 128 GB of storage. So there's sort of a joint winner here because the XPS has the biggest range of specs available because you've got that Core i3 if you don't want to spend too much, and you can go all the way up to an i7 with couple of terabytes of storage and loads of RAM if you need it. But the X Pro is also the winner in terms of it coming with the best specs at the base price, which is obviously more than the other laptops. So the Dell and the Huawei are sort of joint winners here because the XPS 13 has the biggest range of specs on offer, but the X Pro does have the best at its base price, even though it's more expensive. Okay, so it's on to round four, and probably an unusual one for a laptop group test, but we're gonna talk about webcams. Now, that's because Dell has finally managed to put the webcam back in the top bezel. After a couple of years of it being below the screen because of introducing the infinity display, they've managed to get it back up the top here where it should be, despite the bezel being really small. Now, the MacBook does also have it in the top bezel, but as you can see, it's no match for the Dell's bezel there. So bit of a medium win there for the MacBook. And if we switch to the X Pro, now this is quite a cool feature because the webcam is hidden in the keyboard there in this little pop-up key, which is also handy for privacy because you know when it's down, you're not gonna be spied on if that's something you worry about. But it also means that when you are using the webcam, it's pointing upwards at your chin and it's pretty poor angle to actually have a web chat on. Now, this might not mean anything to you because you don't use a webcam, but if you do, something to bear in mind. And again, the winner is the Dell. So round five is battery life. Obviously, you want your laptop to last as long as possible so you don't end up with a dead laptop. We test by looping a video at the same screen brightness across all the laptops so that it's a fair test. Obviously, the spec has to be the model we've been sent in for review, but that's just the way it goes. And the MacBook Air in this test got 10 hours and 45 minutes, which is pretty solid. The Dell got a little bit more at 11 hours and 19 minutes, but the Huawei MateBook X Pro was the winner on battery life with a whopping 14 hours and 9 minutes. Now, that is a little bit lower than all of the manufacturers say, but especially on the Huawei and the Dell, where they claim to be around the 20 hour mark. So it's not as good as they say, but they still won in our test. And good job, X Pro, for going 14 hours. So which one should you buy? Well, in our test, the Dell XPS is the winner. It's the cheapest, it's got the widest range of specs, it's still got decent battery life, it's got that webcam in the bezel, it's got a nice thin and light design. It's basically the best all-rounder out of these three. But that doesn't mean it's necessarily the best for you. Obviously, we haven't talked about the fact that two of them have Windows and one of them has Mac. So if it's an Apple product you're looking for, well, the MacBook Air is the obvious choice. If you want some different features that the Huawei offers, then that might be the right one for you. But in this test, the Dell XPS 13 for 2019 is the winner.